freezing and there aren't enough boats. Half the people on this ship are going to die.
For God's sake, there's women and children down here! Let us out so we can have a chance!
Where are you going? To him!
You jump, I jump, right?
Titanic is an epic, action-packed romance on board the world's most famous ship on a tragic maiden voyage. It's a love story where class holds no bounds between Rose, a first-class aristocrat, and Jack, a young steerage passenger who opens her eyes to what the world has to offer. The romance is played out against the actual events of Titanic's dramatic 4.5-day journey and her spectacular demise. First of all, James, congratulations on the Titanic.
Thanks.
A brilliant film.
I appreciate that. Thank you.
I can only judge it also on the fact that it's such a long film, and yet it didn't seem half as long as that.
Yeah, you know? Good. People have been saying that.
Yeah.
You know, in fact, a lot of people have been asking me, when can we see the long version? You know, the special edition. I'm like, what are you crazy? It's a three-hour movie.
Yeah. With all the marvelous films you've done, directed, written. Why Titanic? Why take on such an amazing story?
Yeah, well, you know, like it's been done many times. Mm-hmm. But there was something about it that, you know, the actual event itself, I thought was like a great novel.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it had all these fantastic characters. And it was, you know, there's a theme that I've done in a lot of my other films, which is what are people like when they're under stress, when they're in a situation where they're facing death or nearly certain death.
Mm.
But how does it bring out the worst in people? How does it bring out the best in people? You know, who's willing to make a sacrifice of themselves for somebody else? All of these things are themes that I've played with. And now here's Titanic, this story that sort of wrote itself that has all of that in it. So I thought this is a perfect playground for me, you know. But the critical element for me was the love story. You know,
to
plant that into it, you know what I mean? To give it a focus and to give it more power, which hadn't been done.
Director James Cameron sits on the A-list with the big guns in Hollywood. His previous blockbusters have put him there. Terminator, Terminator 2, Aliens and True Lies. But many have said that he's made his Schindler's List, an epic romance on the Titanic that he has dreamed of for a decade. A romance which is brought to life by two of the world's hottest young stars. Kate Winslet plays the young Rose, and Leonardo DiCaprio plays the character Jack. Both stars board the Titanic with plenty of on-screen credentials. Kate receiving an Oscar nomination for Sense and Sensibility, and Leonardo an Oscar nominee for What's Eating Gilbert Grape. And of course, he's also known for his sensational role in William Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, and of course, The Basketball Diaries. Congratulations on the Titanic.
Thank you.
What moved you to play the role of Jack Dawson? I mean, you've done some incredible roles in your short career.
Mm-hmm.
Jack Dawson.
Well, mainly this was a completely different sort of experience for me. I've never done a film of this caliber.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, traditionally, I haven't really liked sort of Hollywood system of these disaster films. They haven't really been, you know, my cup of tea. They've been usually sort of heartless pieces about, you know, special effects and not really anything with content.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't want to discriminate against this movie simply because it was a sort of big budget piece. I mean, I saw it simply as, you know, a terrific story that should be told, and that's the reason I did it.
She's 17 years old and she grew up in a very prominent Philadelphia family. However, her father died and left her mother with nothing but a pile of debts. So therefore the mother is desperate for Rose to marry into money.
This is not a game. Our situation is precarious. You know the money's gone.
This wedding is being planned around her, and it's like a death trap to her. There's really nothing that she can do about it.
Don't do it.
And then she goes on to meet Jack Dawson, who is an artist from Wisconsin, and this relationship, an amazing love, surfaces, which is based completely on trust, really, and also he's dead gorgeous. So I think she's sort of taken by that as well.
Why can't I be like you, Jack? Just head out for the horizon whenever I feel like it.
The story that James weaves through this love story, is a great love story. I mean, you played...
Keep your eyes closed, don't pee.
I'm not.
Step up onto the rail. Hold on. Keep your eyes closed. Do you trust me?
I trust you.
Kate in this film?
Shared so much, I mean, on a personal level. He's got lots of my secrets and I've got heaps of his, and I'd never tell a soul.
Add to our romantic story the jealous Billy Zane, and you have a drama from bow to stern.
It's over 100 feet longer than Mauritania, and far more luxurious. Your daughter's far too difficult to impress, Ruth.
You must have loved
the dimension for him, and he completes the triangle, you know, with Kate and Leonardo, and they play off each other beautifully.
You could almost pass for a gentleman.
Almost. It's like a great novel. It's like a great novel that really happened.
This is where we first met.
Coming up, bringing the Titanic. Features that make the Titanic stand out amongst the rest of this year's releases, this is a film that has no bounds. Every aspect of this movie is simply fantastic. It's the attention to detail and the hours of research that has given life to the Titanic. Cameron gathered samples of furnishings, carvings, and fabrics and approached the original manufacturing companies to again fit out the Titanic. Even the shelves of China with the same brand as sailed on the ship's only voyage. The research for this film, what did you do? I mean, the other films like Gilbert Grape, I mean, an extraordinary performance from you, Basketball Diaries, even Romeo and Juliet. Did you have to do much research on this to get the part of Jack Dawson, the free-flowing character?
I mean, for the most part, I've played sort of characters, a lot of demons and people that sort of have, you know, a lot of dark things going on internally.
Mm-hmm.
So it was actually a rough challenge to play somebody who's so free-spirited and open-hearted. I've never really done anything like that before.
Be through the eyes of this wonderful old woman who survived the sinking.
How extraordinary. And it looks the same as it did the last time I saw it. The reflection has changed a bit.
To take it from the present day, and then that wonderful performance by Gloria, who just sets it up as the 101-year-old survivor. To take it from there, and then in her voice, her eyes, her thoughts, you know?
Right.
Where did you come with that idea? I mean, it's a superb stroke, you know?
Yeah, it was... thanks. And she's fabulous.
Oh,
I just Gloria brings such light to the film.
Great,
you know, I love the underwater stuff. Mm. I love the submarines and diving to shipwrecks. I scuba dive all over the world. I dive in shipwrecks. So that's just my sort of personal passion for that stuff. I wanted to do that, and then I wanted to relate it to the past, but I needed a human intermediary for that. And then I started exploring the idea of a living survivor and her reaction to seeing the wreck and recognizing things and remembering the event and going back in time and reliving
home history. They built the Southampton dock and a 77.5 million litre seawater tank in which to sink the ship. To build the Titanic, Cameron obtained the ship's original plans, which had never been released. The film's Titanic was 3/4 of the size of the original.
This ship, I mean, it takes your breath. You go, my God, you know?
That is an enormous task to be able to recreate that, and you're a stickler for doing that, you know?
Yeah, we tried to do it very, very accurately, the way it was, and right down to the way the china was engraved, I mean, the glassware was engraved and all that, but, you know, it's interesting the way you said that, because when I watch the film, talking about for me personally, it's so much more exciting for me to have brought the Titanic back to life than to have sunk it again, because we've all seen it sink, but I don't think we've all seen it live.
Right, three questions. I mean, of all the wonderful films you've done, all the wonderful effects you've come up with, to have to take yourself back as a director with special effects, but this time it's real. I mean, you're creating history or talking about something. I mean, was it hard to do that?
I think it's an order of magnitude harder to create photorealism and historical accuracy in visual effects, because you can't hide behind the creature, the design of the character or something like
that. The ship was the Grand Staircase, which was a five-story grand staircase that ended with a cathedral dome ceiling above it. And we built a contiguous with the first-class dining room capable of seating close to 500 people.
If you look through the reference, you'll find it all.
It comes across on the screen.
When you first saw it, that set, was it awesome?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
It was incredible. The ship was 9/10 the actual size. They might as well have built a bloody boat.
Right.
They did. They built the ship. We were on it. Titanic was real. 3D. Metal, you know? When you suddenly... They're dressing 1,500 extras, and you've got like horse carts and like, you know, these cars shipped over from London, and you know, you get lost in this facade, this.
Now forget it, Boyle. You'll never get next to the likes of her.
Don't come any closer. I'll let go.
No, you won't.
You will not to see that boy again.
I'm the king of the world!
Coming up, sinking the world's most expensive set, and what sets were to be destroyed for the dramatic clash with the iceberg. Almost all of the sets would be flooded and destroyed on camera.
When the ship really starts to go in this film, it's going to be absolutely terrifying.
Suddenly, I felt myself turning into an action hero, going, da-da-da-da-da. You know, I'm running along the deck of the ship, and I'm thinking, my God, I'm actually really loving this. And it was funny. I just never thought of it in that way at all.
Can I do it?
Yes, you did it, camera roll.
Yes! Fuck
yeah! You know, the idea is to create the illusion. When we get to 90 degrees, you know, we're actually having people drop, hit other people, they fall, hit other people. And it's just people are going to be going everywhere. I mean, it must have been horrific.
That's it for stunt team. Nice work.
Making the film Titanic was a mammoth achievement for the cast and crew. An achievement that will go down in cinematic history. This, I think, is a very viable award winner. Do those things mean anything to you?
Oh, they're great, absolutely. I mean, I think the film deserves, you know, some sort of nomination, for sure. I mean, it almost goes beyond a film in some aspects. It's like, you know, out of this world. I think this film is terrific.
Well, I certainly hope you enjoyed